So I went ahead and hid all the details by making everything just show up with plus signs next to them, because that gives me a little bit more real estate and makes it look a little less cluttered over here. Also, notice that if you ever find yourself in the position of not being able to move your layers on top of each other or change the order of them, it's because you're stuck underneath the cylinder over here. And just make sure that you're always on the far left icon. You might have to ask nicely, like three times, but you want to be under the list by drawing order, and that's going to allow you to change the layers should you want to do that. Okay, so what I'd like to do now is go ahead and add the campus parking. And what this is telling me is true or false is this location for parking. And what I'd like to do is use this to create a layer that could tell someone what's the name of this parking lot, or basically show the unique ID for each parking lot. So to do that, we're going to basically, what we want to do in general terms is we want to convert a Boolean raster into an object raster. And to do that, we're going to use a tool called region group. And it's under spatial analyst, and you should be able to find it in your search. But rather than double click on that to open it up, let's go ahead and just add it to our model. And so if I open up the model and I go over here and I drag and drop this guy on, and now I go over here and drag and drop this guy on, and then I go up here and use the magic wand to say use the campus parking as my input into the region group, then this should be pretty good. But let's look a little bit into what the parameters are for the region group tool. So the input raster is campus parking, that sounds good. The output raster is going to be Othello 4 parking lots as objects. Let's say save. Okay, so now deep breath. I'm talking to myself. So this is what I'd like to draw on the board. But basically, region group is going to decide whether or not locations in this raster should be grouped together to form unique objects based on whether or not two locations have the same value and touch. Is that fair enough? And then you just have to decide basically a touch rule. So do you want touching to be that they share a side? And so, like, right, we're talking about pixels, and so there's four sides to a pixel. Or do you want it to be that they share both a side and a corner? Like, can you touch diagonally? And I'm going to say that we're just going to be conservative about touching, and we're going to say that you just have to share a side. There's no diagonal touching going on. But this is something that we need a strategy for. Like, how do you pick a touch rule? Okay, and then we're going to leave this one just default, and we'll talk about that perhaps in lecture, but in general, we're not going to worry about that too much in this course. And then the last bit is that I would like you not to worry, but to type in 0 there. And so this is basically saying that because 0 is being used as our background, that it should ignore it and not try to form groups out of zeros. And then if I say, apply and OK, and then if I save the model, and then if I grab this cursor and I select the region group, and then I right-click on it, I can hit run, right? Because I don't want to run the entire model, because we've already executed this. I just want to run this new piece of the model. So if I right-click on it and say run, it'll flush red, no errors over here. I'm going to close that. I'm going to save this again. And then let's go look at what we got. And so if it doesn't show up again, remember that you can always refresh. But I think in general, these outputs will show up over here. And now if I drag and drop, it's this kind of, again, I'm not too into rain clouds. Like, I went to grad school in Santa Barbara. So let's get some color here. Right? Again, like, I went to grad school in California, so let's put the rainbow on this. And curious curious rainbow that it's just using 26s, and you may get something different here, but anyway. Okay, so let's process this. I think that this guy right here is going to have the ID or the value 1. Am I right? Yeah. And I think this one is going to be 2. Am I right? Yeah. And I think this guy actually is probably going to be 3. And then this guy is 4. So there's, and then I think if we went all the way down here, and so I'm going to grab the zoom tool and go all the way at the bottom, I think probably this guy is going to have ID 40. Yeah. Now, in other words, there's a logic to, or not a logic, but the way that this region group works is that there's going to be this little moving window that starts up here at the very top left and moves all the way across like this and scans. And it's this little neighborhood window that when it finally hits a 1 value, and this is basically like, this is going to be landfall for this little filter that's moving across the filter. It's going to make landfall here, and so this is going to be essentially the first group that it makes. This is going to be the second landfall, and this is going to be the second group. So in a way, you can think about this as kind of creating objects or basically naming islands with an explorer or a navigator who has a real kind of strict route that begins in the upper left and follows across an entire row and then comes over here and scans the next row. And so anyway, you have 40. 40 is your highest value, which means that you have 40 parking lots, and 0 is still being used as the background. Okay, but cool. So we made objects or maybe islands out of, you know, that's another way to think about it. This is an archipelago and these are individual islands. Okay, that's it.